explicit group knowledge. So this is about process models, rules in structures, historic documents, and anecdotes. So it's what's on the door, right? This is instructions for who is using this room, right? But normally with an elevator, there should be an instruction about what happens in case of fire. What should you do? The first step is to remain calm, and the second one is to contact the porter, and the third one, I forgot, or not use the elevator. So there's explicit sources like documented rules, business plans, laws, and memos, and there's unofficial, like, sealed documents and stories and anecdotes that you only tell in the coffee room and whatsoever, right? So, and all of this is kind of group knowledge. People know about it, right? And it makes sense in a certain community, in a certain practice. So, validity is a problem. What does it mean? If you look at regulations or laws, like the regulation that the car should have three braking lights, one in the middle, and 15 years ago, there was an intention to do this. And then at a certain moment, it was installed. And then some cars couldn't install it. And then at a certain moment, it's officially still valid, but nobody cares anymore. And at a certain moment, it could be overruled. Right? So any document could have kind of each of these levels, or one of these levels, sorry. Right? And so be aware if you find a document to find out what's the validity of this document. There's a lot of rules that are put on packages and in manuals just because of insurance things. The insurance company requires you to put this on the package. Or the insurance company requires you to. Right? And it's not describing how people would behave or how people think it makes sense to behave, but it's because. So you really need to understand the validity of all these documents. What does it mean there on the door? Should I do this when I'm leaving for a lunch break? Should I really put all the tables exactly at the same location and be shifted it around? Maybe not. Maybe it's for the cleaners to leave things as they found it. I'm not sure, right? So you have to find out. You have to find out for each type of document or information that's in space. There's lots of shared knowledge here around you. There's pictures of coffee containers, there's pictures of different mouses and so on. So they all are kind of knowledge we have if we look at it. In practice, a lot of this information could be found inside the shop of your customer or actually even outside, like at the shop window. There's information at the shop window, could be information in the street. And then there's in the outside world, like you could find information by using Google. You could find information by using the customer in his office, in his house, or on his website. So if you have to do this, make pictures, collect, transcribe, and interpret the validity. What does it actually mean, this information? Well, there's an exercise for the coffee break. Study the what to do poster and try to remember what is the main message. So you have to remain calm, call the emergency number, never use the elevator, right, or something like that. So you could try out. Some pieces are short, and some pieces I